Welcome to Professor Matt, Electronics for Beginners. Today we are going to learn about resistors. We know electrical resistance is opposition to the flow of current in an electric circuit. The resistor's resistance limits the flow of electrons through a circuit. This is a conductor. Assume it has zero resistance. If we apply a voltage difference, then the electrons start to move through the conductor. A moving electron flow is a negative current flow. We can measure the amount of current using an ammeter. Here we have very high current, because the conductor has no resistance to slow down the electrons. They move at full speed. Let's consider another conductor, but it has a resistor. Let's apply the same amount of voltage, like the first one. Electrons start to flow, but electrons have no other option. They have to go through the resistor. Let's look at the ammeter reading. It's less than the first reading. Because the resistor limits the electron flow. Let's try another conductor that has two resistors in series. Current flow has to pass both obstacles. So the ammeter reading is lesser than earlier. Likewise, we can add more resistors in series and increase the resistance. This is the symbol of resistor. The total resistance is now R1. If we add another resistor that has R2 resistance, the total resistance becomes R1 plus R2. Let's add another R3 resistor in series. The total resistance increase furthermore. Now the total resistance is R1 plus R2 plus R3. So in general, the total resistance of the series resistors are equal to the sum of individual resistance. Let's go back again. We know series resistors reduce the current. Assume this resistor only allows I1 current to go through it. Now the ammeter reading is I1. What happens if we connect two resistors that has same resistance in parallel and apply the same voltage across those? Each resistor allows I1 current to go through it. Now the ammeter reading is equal to I1 plus I1, that is 2I1. You see, the current has increased. That means the total resistance has decreased. Using parallel resistors, we can reduce the resistance. Look at this circuit. We, R and I are the voltage, resistance and current between points A and B. If we add an R1 resistor between point A and B, it will pass I1 current through it. Current has no other way to go from A to B. So, the total current is equal to I1. Using the Ohm's law, we can replace the current by using voltage and resistance. Now we can remove the term voltage from both sides. We are getting an equation like this. Right. Let's add another resistor parallel to the R1, like this. This new R2 resistance allow I2 current to pass it. Now the current has two ways to go from A to B. So the total current is equal to the sum of these two currents, I1 plus I2. We can replace the I using Ohm's law and simplify the equation like this. We can keep adding resistors and continue this for more parallel resistors. For three parallel resistors, we can build an equation like this. In a parallel resistor circuit, the inverse of the total resistance is equal to the sum of inverse of each individual resistor.